Hey, what's up?
Being at so many games and coming to cheer us in different places. And Selena, we've already talked about some of the things that are happening for this summer, and your mind is churning how we're going to get there. And these are great things for all of you to be here to share and coming from great distances. And I can't say enough about our former players who are here. Doug Miller, Evan Harris, Charlie Baker still here. Charlie Baker's in there in the back. So many of you here, Thomas Mannix, Fred Schernecker. I know we have some special guests that we're going to introduce, and incredibly special former players that are here. We're going to take care of that. But thank all of you for being here with us this evening to make this a wonderful evening, a wonderful event.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Vince said if I could make it up that first step, I could speak tonight, so I decided to come up the easy way. Ladies and gentlemen, Coach Amaker and other coaches, members of the great Harvard basketball team, parents, loyal Harvardites, and family friends, I'm honored to have this opportunity to speak to you tonight. I was out on the campus today, and we happened to run into several of the basketball players. And Keith Wright was one of them, and I asked, how long should I speak, Keith? And he said, well, you can speak as long as you want to, but in 15 minutes, we're going to walk out of here. We'll try to honor that, Keith. I come to you as a former Harvard athlete who was fortunate enough to play on the 45-46 basketball team. Tonight we're going to celebrate Harvard men's basketball with particular emphasis on these young men that have done so well this year, and we'll be hearing more about them as the evening goes on. 4 years of college ball, and my biggest man ever was 6'3". Our center, the year that we went to the NCAA, was Lou Deasy, and he was about 6'3". Also, being small, we couldn't jump either. We never even thought of going up to the rim. A lot of you guys can get up there 2 feet above the rim and stick your arm down in the basket. And we shot fouls underhand, and we wore short pants. So those are some of the things that were a little different there. Now, having said all that, there's no doubt in my mind that today's players are taller, stronger, they can jump, they can run, they make moves that we never even thought about. The skills are much, much better. Most of the players play at the game the year round. We didn't do that so much back in my day.
Seattle, when Tommy won his 250th career game, opening for 14.